Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Ilham Taufik. I'm from Tourism Seminar Class, supervised by Professor Dr. Azila Kasim. Okay, let's me start the tourism development and the best tourism practice in Portugal. Okay, we start Portugal tourism in the economy. In 2018, the sector contribute 8% of GVA and grow twice as fast as the overall economy, 8% compared with 3.9%. Portugal's tourism sector has exhibited significant recent growth, mainly led by the increase in both volume and value of intercontinental market in the America and Asia. In 2018, overseas visitor total 22.8 million and increased 7.5% compared with 2017. The five leading international source markets in order of importance were United Kingdom, Germany, Spain, France, and Brazil. Together, these top five countries account for 58.5% of demand. Okay, next, the promoting innovation through the Tourism Innovation Center in Portugal. Tourism Innovation Center Portugal, or NIST, is the main project of Tourism 4.0 to promote the transition of the Portuguese tourism sector to the digital economy and to foster innovation and entrepreneurship. The center was set up as a private association in 2019 with founding partners include Airport of Portugal, BPI Bank, Portugal Highway, Google, Microsoft Portugal, Millennium BCP, NOS or Telecom, and Turismo de Portugal. This provide a quote for the center financing and expertise. NIST aims to support the digital transformation of the tourism sector and become a global center for innovation. The center's main objectives are promote entrepreneurship, innovation, and research tourism. Support company that develop a creative and innovative approach, create innovation laboratories in partnership with universities, tourism school, incubator and knowledge centers, and produce and transfer knowledge to the company. This is the main area of activity here: digital economy for tourism startup, incubation and acceleration service in partnership with the ecosystem, advising micro, small, and medium size for tourism enterprise, develop of new product and technology, and experimentation, creation, and validation of prototypes. International promotion of startup and innovation, and the last, monitoring international digital tourism trends. Next, the reinforcement of the environmental efficiency in the tourist hour. First, the revision of the Tourism Establishment Administrative Decree, mandatory sustainability requirement focusing on water consumption efficiency, energy and waste production, and the creation of financing instrument for energy efficiency, water and bio waste for housing and catering, including implementation of certification. So it will be the responsibility of the Turismo de Portugal to ensure the implementation of the plan, which includes initiative and project to be developed in close articulation with the institutional partner identified, some of which have already been signposted and are under development, and other to be initiated. The aims is to ensure the development and commitment of entities and company in the tourism sector, academia, as well as other sector of activity such as the environment and the sea. Okay, for the last, what Malaysia can learn from Turismo de Portugal? Okay, there are signs that Malaysia tourism industry is stuck in a comfort zone. Existing tourism products are becoming tired and unattractive due to the lack of creativity and innovation, resulting from the over-dependence on the government and a silo mentality. The inability to harness a service culture has resulted in a real or perceived deterioration in service quality. Poor destination management has also led to unsustainable physical development and negative tourist experience. Finally, an over-reliance on traditional marketing and promising has left Malaysia behind in terms of embracing smart tourism. Hence, the need to reinvent and transform the industry so as to remain competitive. This is sourced from Ministry of Tourism, Art and Culture Malaysia.